Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Welcome back to Cocktails After Dark. It is November 2020, and I have not filmed one of these cocktail videos since January 2020, so it's been quite a while. And I don't know why I left it so long. There's been other stuff happening on the planet, I think, that sort of maybe distracted me a little bit. And so for the first time back, we're going to do a recipe out of this little book. This is a 1946 printing of Mr. Boston's Deluxe Official Bartender's Guide. And this particular copy belonged to my Uncle Bob. And when I was down in Little Rock in February, my cousins gave this to me. And this book is gold. There are so many recipes in here. And it is essentially a marketing device that old Mr. Boston Distillery started right after Prohibition as a way to get some recipes into the hands of potential customers and sell alcohol. So it is a treasure trove of recipes, but more important than that are all of my Uncle Bob's handwritten notes that are in the back of the book. And he took copious notes about everything that he learned about cocktails, about the ingredients. He took down what they were, where they were made, the correct pronunciation, something that I could probably maybe take a leaf out of his book on. And his notes are just absolutely fantastic. I'm really glad I have this book. So today, we're going to do a recipe called the Mary Pickford Cocktail. And I chose that in sort of a strange way. Mary Pickford was a silent film star when silent films were all the rage. She is one of the founding people of the Academy Awards, and she's Canadian. She's from Toronto. So she was America's sweetheart in the 1920s. Very famous actress who, you know, has maybe fallen by the wayside at this point. This is a rum cocktail, and it's a pretty straightforward rum cocktail. So I'm going to use this Diplomático rum. It is from Venezuela. It's a pretty nice dark rum. And I know that this recipe from their book used dark rum. And the next ingredient is pineapple juice. So in that goes. Then it calls for a very small amount of maraschino. In that goes. And the same of grenadine. This is our homemade grenadine. It's quite nice. Keeps really well in the fridge. Next into the shaker is some ice. And we give that a shake. Okay, so I've got two Nicanora glasses that are iced. Now we will double strain. You don't have to double strain, but it just gets those little bits of ice shards out. And let's see if I can do this equally. Oh, not too bad. And there you go. Hey, Jules.
Hey, Glenn.
Jules,
hey,
has made it. Jules has made it for Cocktails After Dark.
I don't often get to make cocktails after dark.
So this is a rum cocktail called the Mary Pickford Cocktail.
Oh, how very Canadian of you.
Yes, I thought so. Cheers. Huh. How almost sideways tiki, but not tiki.
It's kind of refreshing in that it's not overly sweet or overly fruity somehow.
Yeah, so it's just rum, a little bit of maraschino. The major fruit flavor is pineapple juice.
Ah, so that would explain why it's not so citrusy.
Yeah, it's quite nice. Although it needs, you know, and a beach chair and a pool.
Really, you need the beach chair and pool is really what you're looking for.
Yes,
you're indifferent to the umbrella and the, you know, banana dolphin on
no.
the side. You just want the beach.
But all of those things scream, I'm at the beach having a good time. This is this is quite refreshing. It's nice. I think that rum goes quite well in this.
Yeah. I clearly am enjoying it.
So there you have it. The Mary Pickford cocktail from the 1946 version of Old Mr. Boston using Venezuelan rum in place of the Old Mr. Boston rum, which doesn't exist. does not exist. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.